Ever since I moved here, I've been meaning to build a zip line in the backyard. Now, unfortunately, we don't have any zip line equipment, but we do have some Kevlar string. Now, the Kevlar rope we have is rated for about 2,000 pounds. At least that's what the Chinese website says. But we want to make sure that the hooks we're installing into the garage can also take the load. So right now, we've actually got a hydraulic car jack, and we're going to see what will break first, the rope or the hook. All right, so the rope snapped, the hook stayed strong, which is good. That means they're not going to rip out of the garage. To see if the rope will actually be strong enough for our zipline application, we did some basic calculations to see what the tension would be. For a sag of 5 feet, we found the tension would be 1,800 pounds. If we graph the relationship between sag and tension, you'll find that if we tighten the rope any more, we're likely to break it. Now, since our Kevlar is only rated to 2,000 pounds, that means we're working with basically no safety factor. To put that in perspective, a commercial zipline would probably have a safety factor of around 10. So if we wanted to do this right, we'd need something that could support 20,000 pounds. So we should probably wait until we can find a better rope than this Kevlar.
Just do it! Make your dreams come true!
I guess we should do it. All right, so what we've done is we've attached two 2x4s to the outside of the garage and bolted them into the structure. Then we've attached the hooks to the 2x4s, and while this might not be up to building code, it's not going to break under my weight on the zip line. At least we hope not.
So I'm standing in this sketchy treehouse, Princess Castle, and we're running the zip line to it. The scary part is when you jiggle it, the whole thing rocks, and we're attaching this giant cable to it, so might fall over.
All right, zip line test number one. Alright, so we worked the kinks out of the system and it works way better than we thought it would. So, let's have some fun with it. Did you know grapefruit juice is highly flammable?
It has to be expired though.
So we answered the question, yes, you can zipline on string, but let's raise the stakes. Can you zipline through fire? Alright, that was a ton of fun, but as you know, probably not that safe, and we're kind of expecting the string's going to break one of these days. That being said, if you guys want to make a zipline at home, like this video, and if we get over 15,000 likes, we'll do a tutorial video showing you how to make a safe zipline with proper equipment that you can make at home. This video is made possible by our supporters on Patreon. We couldn't do it without you guys. If you want to help us grow this channel even more and work on even cooler projects, always like our videos, comment, share, and consider supporting us on Patreon. Now the only problem with this, it's getting back to the start. Luckily the deck's here, so I can kind of pull myself back up.